Did you know we rely on bees for the pollination of around 64% of all crops? While you might be familiar only with the honeybee, there are many other types of bee, including the leafcutter. Leafcutter bees are a family of solitary bees. Because they don't have hives or queens to protect, solitary bees are often much more docile than the typical honeybee and are a lot less likely to sting. Even though these bees don't produce honey, they are important and efficient pollinators and are great at preserving biodiversity. It's easy and cheap to make your very own unique leafcutter bee habitat. To make this habitat of my own design, first you will need to gather your materials. I will be using 3 large outer tubes. These are just the cardboard rolls inside tape rolls, like duct tape or scotch tape, but depending on its height, you will need more or less to make sure the bee box is the length of a straw. I will also be using 21 inner tubes. These were depleted label rolls donated from our local UPS. If you don't have these exact items, that's okay. You might use other cardboard items like small boxes or paper towel rolls. By using cardboard, you can repurpose items that might otherwise end up in a landfill. I'll also be using roughly 60 paper straws, which will act like how holes bored into a tree would in the wild, and roughly 7 or 8 feet of colorful duct tape. I am using blue and purple, which are among the most attractive colors for bees, but any colors work great. To assemble the habitat, take 1 large roll and cover one side with tape. This will act as the back of our bee box. Next, put in 7 small rolls so they fit inside firmly. Then, put paper straws in every crevice so there's plenty of places for the leaf cutters to lay their eggs. You can place them randomly or put them in a pattern, like I will. After all your straws have been placed, we can start building the rest of the box. Stack the next 2 layers of inner tubes. Then, stack the next 2 layers of outer tubes. It's almost complete. Wrap the habitat in strips of duct tape. This will not only keep the tubes together, but also helps to waterproof it so it will last longer. The best place to mount one of these habitats is under the eaves of your house, but anywhere is fine as long as they are placed firmly. We used these metal hanger straps, which we shaped around the bee box and drilled into our house. Female leafcutter bees will crawl into each hole and create a bed of pollen. Then they will lay their eggs on top and seal off a chamber using a leaf, or in the cases of mason bees, using mud or clay. Each female bee can lay several eggs in each tube. They'll lay females towards the back, since these eggs will take longer to mature and are less likely to be killed by predators. Female bees are extremely important to growing populations. After all the bees mature and move out, females born in the habitat will return during their breeding season to lay their own eggs, meaning the habitats will be reused year after year and can even see exponential growth.